And today I'm going to be showing you how to make a Pokemon stack. This one's mine, like a binder, and this one's mine. So just a bit of a preview of how it's going to look like. And then, yeah, that's how it's going to look like. And except I'm making a bit of a bigger one this time, so yeah. So first, what you're going to want to do is fold your paper horizontally, just like that, and like crease it down. Okay. Make sure it's pretty easy. And then open up your paper, and then you want to take your piece of paper and then like fold the paper in that crease. Like in the crease. And you do the same for the other side. Okay. So then after that, you wanna fold it like this, not vertically. Oh, sorry guys, you can't see that. So after you got these two pieces, you wanna fold it like that, vertically. And I'm gonna place that down too. Now you wanna open up the whole entire paper, and you can see that you got some pieces. And now you wanna fold the paper in the crease again. And same for the other side. And make sure it's pretty easy. So you'll have a good take your corner and fold it like this onto that line. And same for all three of the other side. Oh, sorry, you can see that. Then you put the paper and you do the same thing. Like onto this little grid line you see. You fold your paper like this on that grid line. Okay. And then you fold it in half. Just for some more creasing. And then you flip it over like this. Now what you want to do is you want to fold your paper this way onto that crease that's in the middle, and same for the other side. Okay, now that you've done that, you want to flip your paper over, just like that, and you want to kind of fold it evenly so you get a good, just like that. So this is how it should be looking right now. So now you want to fold your paper in half. Just like that. And then you fold it like this. Oh, sorry guys, you can see that. So after you have it like this, you fold it in half. So it's basically should be like this. Fold it this way, open it up, and fold it this way. There you go. Now you add your cards in. Wait a second. Okay. Now let me get your card. And you basically just add them in like this. I'm gonna make three more of these and I'll be back when they're done. So yeah, bye guys. So I made three more. So my first one, second one, third one, and fourth one. Now I'm gonna connect them all up. So basically what you have to do is you have to kind of like face them in the right direction. So you take the two corners of where you want to open it and you want to stick it so when you close it, it's open. So let's put some glue on. And then fix the camera so you can see. So what you want to do is close over your second deck of what you want to do. So put glue all over. Oh, and glue stick. But you could do also liquid glue. I'd rather prefer this glue because it doesn't get out and messy. Oh, and if it's purple glue, it's fine because purple glue comes clear. So then you take your end of it and basically just stick it on there. There we go. So basically right now you have two flaps where you can put your cards in. And now you gotta put the rest of your flaps on. So make sure like it's pretty even as well as on the movie. Like not the blue light when you're putting it on. Putting it on, otherwise it looks gonna look a bit messy. Now take the corner, the bottom, and just stick it on nice and evenly. This is what I was thinking about putting it on pretty even. So this is how it is right now. Now for the last one, this is the last time I get to solve it through. Sorry guys, if you can't see it. I'm just making sure it's nice and secure by putting on a lot and a lot. Oh, and the more glue you put, the more secure it's going to be. And then you, wrong way. So yeah, make sure you put it in the wrong way or it's going to be completely wrong and you don't want to really know. As again, as I said before, if you put purple glue on, make your card deck it in the middle because I'm just going to. So there you go, you have taped all of them on and this is how they look. below, and there's this one little step. So this is optional. I just like to do it because it looks better. But I put like some glue on the flaps here. And the back too. Oh, sorry, I was going to stop talking about these back. Okay, so there you guys go. You guys can decorate it by saying putting Pokemon on the top. But I'm just going to leave it like this for now. So, hope you guys enjoyed how to make this DIY Make It Yourself binder. I think it's really cool because you don't even buy it. Yeah, it's like the same as the one that you buy from the store. So, yeah, hope you guys liked this video and please subscribe, click the like button, and don't forget to turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any videos. Bye!